In this final video on energy processing, we'll talk about what happens to the breakdown of food molecules for energy in the absence of oxygen. We'll recall this type of respiration fermentation, or anaerobic respiration. Aerobic means with oxygen, anaerobic means without oxygen gas. Different types of organisms will approach fermentation or anaerobic respiration in different ways. In yeast and bacteria, the most common form is through what's called alcoholic fermentation. In this process, glucose is broken down during glycolysis into pyruvate, as we would normally see, but then that pyruvate, instead of being broken down into carbon dioxide, is converted into ethyl alcohol. Animals do not typically perform alcoholic fermentation. However, we do have a form of fermentation that can happen within our muscles and within our cells, and it is known as lactic acid fermentation. We'll talk about these two processes and why they happen. If you recall, with oxidative phosphorylation, high-energy electron carriers are dropping off their electrons at the electron transport chain, and oxygen is there to pick up those electrons at the end of the chain. Well, if oxygen gas is not present, those electrons cannot keep passing down that electron transport chain, and those shuttle buses will get filled up and not be able to empty. And so, for this reason, when oxygen is absent, instead of those high-energy electrons being taken all the way to the electron transport chain, they're dropped back off with pyruvate, and this is when the conversion occurs, either into ethyl alcohol or into lactic acid. Now, the thing about both ethanol and lactic acid is that these are still energy-rich molecules. There's a lot of energy still in them. This can be evidenced with alcohol because it's flammable if you have a high enough proof or concentration. Within the bodies of humans and other organisms, instead of the production of carbon dioxide and alcohol, these pyruvate molecules are converted into lactic acid, and this can start to generate that burning sensation in muscles when you're doing things like sprinting or playing in an athletic event or some sort of workout regime. For alcoholic fermentation, not only is alcohol produced, but also carbon dioxide gas. This happens in bread dough. As the bread dough rises, what's happening is that bubbles of carbon dioxide gas are being formed. When the bread is baked, all of the alcohol leaves the bread. However, the air bubbles remain behind. That's what makes the bread light and fluffy. Conversely, if the goal is to brew beer or to brew wine, often the carbon dioxide is released, and what's kept is the ethyl alcohol. And occasionally, something like a sparkling wine or a champagne will include both carbon dioxide and ethanol produced by the brewing yeast. Whether we're talking about alcoholic fermentation or lactic acid fermentation, the only energy gains that are received are those that come through glycolysis. And so only 2 ATP are produced when oxygen is absent, compared to the over 30 ATP that are released when oxygen is present. As a large animal with high energy demands, we cannot survive simply through anaerobic respiration. We need to have oxygen in order to live. Hopefully, this journey through the metabolism of eukaryotic cells helps to understand a bit about how we get our energy and also why oxygen gas is so important. Thanks for your attention, and I'll see you in the next video.